Welcome back, guys. Thank you so very much for clicking on my video. My name is Chiwendu Madibia and I do videos on lifestyle and travel. And if that is what you like to watch, please don't forget to like and subscribe. And please click on the notification bell so that it tells you whenever I post a video. So this is gonna be the first time I'm talking about, well, I always talk about being reasonably cheap. Oh, I don't want to say cheap, but then my channel is all about getting the best deal. I love to do videos on anything lifestyle, so be it anything, as long as it has to do with like improving yourself and shopping and saving money while you're at it, that's my thing. So for today's video, we're going to be talking about money. I know this is not a good time to be talking about money because some people are out of job, but this is just a little distraction and also a motivation, a way to motivate you to think about things relating to money. This is a topic that is a little bit I don't want to say complicated, but difficult for people to actually talk about or even want to deal with. It is different for every country. America is a debted country. You want to survive in America, you have to owe a debt. My mentality changed when I got into America. Back home, my mentality was, you need a car, you have to save for a car. You need a house, you have to save for your house, you know. Well, in America, it doesn't work that way. It's different anyways. Today's video, I'm gonna be just showing you ways, not ways, just a fun video, but in a way that can motivate you to do something in terms of saving. So last year, sometime last year, I walked into Walmart, and normally I have to go to their clearance section. I don't care. It is Walmart, yes, but they still have clearance section. And be me, the clearance lady, I have to branch there. So I got there and I saw this container. I think it was for $2 or $3. And the first thing that came into my mind is get it and use it to like dump your coins, you know, any change. Because in my purse, it just weighed down and expand the leather or whatever, and I really don't want that. And it's not every time that I leave the house that I want to leave with a coins pouch. So I decided to get this to dump my coins, as you can see. But then when I got home, I started dumping my coins. Yeah, and I never had that idea that I want to save, because it wasn't a saving thing for me. I just want to, you know, because in Barbados we do it also, we like dump all our coins in a container and then we'll take it to the bank and get a the paper money. So it was something that I normally do, you know. So but my thing was just to dump it, because I do not want it in my purse anymore. It was just destroying my purse. So that was how this whole magic started. So a day I had a lot, some paper, like a dollar in my purse. I was like, you know what, nobody carries money anymore. Like, you use your debit card for all everything. Like, really, there's a secure way to make payment, and even if your purse go missing, you know that you can call your bank and cancel your card immediately, or your credit card. So yeah, so I decided to dump every time I get like $2. I think they have $2 change, $2 paper, but $5, $10, or whatever money I have just in my pocket and in my purse, and I think it's just, I'm not gonna be using it for anything anyway, so I just dump it here. And it never got serious, because I never really was saving. And trust me, I have taken money from this container, almost more than $200 for this container, because it was not a saving game. It was just me dumping my coins. Sorry, I know I keep on saying that. Then And that is how it started. Every time I go return stuff, I get back change. Whenever I get back, if it's like, some people, even though it's I use my debit card mainly, some stores like to give you back money in return. Some will say no, you have to, they have to pay you back or give you back your money from whichever means you pay with. So because I use my debit card more when I shop, like people like places like Macy's, and I think TJ Maxx does it sometimes, they send it straight to my card, but places like Walmart and these other small places, they give you back the cash, and every time they give me the cash, I dump it in here. The only time I did went to the bank and take money and dump me here is when, like about 2 weeks ago, when I got paid my bonus at work. I think it was $300 a bonus, so I took $300 out of my money, because it's not my, I mean, it's my money, but it's not something, a money that I was expecting or I worked for or is a gift. Well, nobody really gifts to you when it, you know, when you get to a certain age. Welcome to my world. So nobody gives you any gift to you anymore. Anyway, I have been gifted monetary gift, you know, I don't want to lie, from, you know, somebody obviously, but so I took the bonus and dumped it in here. So without further ado, I think I have dug enough. I'm gonna go ahead and count how much is in this jar. Oh, I didn't even know this was a challenge on YouTube. I think it was yesterday, because I always wanted to shoot this video, but I told myself, I don't know if people will really like, things like this, because, I mean, it's money, and people are very particular when it comes to money, you know. So, but 2 days ago, I saw this challenge going on YouTube about saving $1, $2, $1, $5, or $10 for a period of a year, a period of a month, a period of 6 months, to see how much you could save every $5. But that was not the issue with me. I was just doing my own thing. Okay, so I'm gonna bring the camera closer so we could count this. So I brought this little book that I'm gonna record how much, you know. So money, alive. So please pause the video and comment how much you think this is gonna be. Wow, I think next thing I'm gonna do is I'm not gonna touch this money. I'm gonna put it back and try till July and see how much I will come up with. But for now, let's know. Let's see how much is in here. I have the coins, but I'm not gonna count the coins, because that's gonna prolong the video. So let's begin this counting. I have this $100. I'm gonna go ahead and put it right there. Let's do 20s, because I see more 20s, you know. So guys, comment and tell me how, you know, you've been saving this period. I mean, for me, it's gonna be a little bit harder to save now, you know, because of the method that I'm using. Because I do not want to go to the bank to withdraw money to dump into this, because it does not make sense. For me, well, it was not a thing for me. I was just dumping my coins. So tell me what you think is the easiest way that you have been acquiring that coin and saving it, because a sister would like to know, you know. Let's teach each other about these tricks and become billionaires. We can do it. Also, those people who are billionaires are not, they don't have four heads, they only have two heads like us. But well, this is the 20s. I'm gonna put it right there. I'm gonna do the ones. And also comment, let me know how you've been surviving during this period of no work, you know, when you have to stay home. It's really difficult right now. But you know what? There's life. We have to be grateful. Life is the most important thing you have to pray for. Because if you don't have life, then or good health, then all these challenges and all these things that we're fighting for or trying to acquire is just, it just doesn't, would not make no sense. So well, it looks like I have a lot of 20s, right? I think I will say this is probably like 4. No. Because I wasn't like an intense saving for me, and because I've been deep behind in this to do stuff. I think I'll probably say maybe around $450 to like $500. Because there's a lot of ones. I mean, how much do you think a one will be? I only probably had like one hundred. Yep, that's only. I don't see any other hundred. So I watch videos of people when they crack like their big piggy bank. They have like 2,000. I mean, they save for 2-3 years and then they break it. They have like 2-3 thousand, and some people save for like 6 months and they have more than $1,000. You know, but you know what, they were saving, but I was not, so I was just having fun. Okay, so now that we have this 5, we're gonna go ahead and count. So this is 100 already. I'm gonna count 20. This is, I like to count my money like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. 28 is like 560. Do you agree with me? I hope I'm doing my math right. Yes, all right. And then 100. Oh, sorry about that. And then I'm gonna do the 10th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So this is 90. The 10 is 90. This is 5s. We don't have that much 5, but let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9, that would be 45. And then let's do the ones, obviously. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. So that is $31. Okay, so for a grand total of, okay, let's see, 16 plus 6 is 22. So 22, bring the one over. 5, 6, 7. Oh, bring the two, so it'd be $826. Ha! Wow, I was way off. Wow. For no reason, I don't know. This has a lot of $1 coins also, not just like penny or dime. You also have like a dollar coin. So I'm guessing maybe like $15 is in here, or maybe $20. Yeah, because I dropped a lot of $1 coins in there, because I went to a store and they gave me $15 worth of $1. Actually, I accompanied a friend and they gave her that and she gave it to me and I dumped it in there. Okay, so yeah. So this is This is it. Thank you so much. This is to tell you that you can literally save your money without even knowing it. So without further ado, thank you. I'll see you in my next video.